This is Hey Garden Guy Charlie Stocker with Hey Garden Guy Charlie Stocker, Facebook, YouTube, HeyGardenGuy.com, where we answer your questions on a 24-hour basis. Any question you may have regarding what is this particular bug and why is it creating the problems it is for me? Identify this plant. What is this disease and what can I do about it? It's so we learn together, we raise our garden IQs together, and in addition, we have videos that we do every day, new ones, only about 3 minutes long, and then we put those on our Facebook and YouTube for you to benefit from the goings-on of the community of the tri-state. I'm with Chris. And Chris has been one of the forces behind this community garden, which everyone can come to. It's right across the street from Pierre Funeral Home. It's made up of a 20 by 48 torn down building that they, over the last 5 years, have refurbished into what we're looking at now, which is very, very exciting. What do we have in this bed? And they're all about 4 by 8.
Yeah, they're all about 4 by 8. In this bed, we have green beans, we have regular snap beans, and the Italian Roma beans. They're coming close to the end of their life. If you can see, they've got a little mosaic on them. That happens with the beans. It's a little fungus, and so...
But you don't worry about that.
No, but the beans are still growing, and the kids are still picking them. And then
how many pickings did you get off of this?
Oh, gosh, probably, 10 pounds.
And what's the variety? This all right if you
yeah,
don't know
just it. Italian Romas, Blue Lake.
Okay, Blue Lake. Okay.
Blue Lake and Italian Romas.
And what do we have here?
We have
marigolds on both ends.
Marigolds.
Why marigolds?
Because they're a deterrent to the insects.
And they really are.
And they really keep the insects out of the garden.
They are repellent for a lot of pests that normally you would have in here.
Yes.
Tell me about the signs. You've got signs everywhere
in this community garden. We have a lot of really cute signs. Snickerdoodle Art, which is one of the businesses on Franklin Street that donate to the garden, had a painting party, and there were adults and kids and people just walking in, and they painted all the signs, all the bed marker signs, the pictures of them that are on there, and that was their donation to the garden. They did the volunteer sign that Emily is painting. They did the pollinator signs out front. And it was just a great
So it
addition.
Takes a village.
It takes a village,
It
yes.
takes a village yes. to raise a community garden. But the return is all of these kids involved now.
Yes.
They come in at night. They come during the day.
Right.
It's an educational project. This is fantastic. What's in this bed?
In this bed is broccoli. Broccoli, kale, and the Swiss chard is just starting to come on now. We had kale on the other side, but it got the harlequin beetles that you can see right here. There's some harlequin beetles on this kale.
And what kind of damage do they do?
They have dinner on there.
Okay.
They eat it, and then they really put out a nasty stink. So this kale is about done, and the broccoli is about done, so it's probably in the next week or so going to get pulled up and plant some winter crops, spinach, radishes, and beets are
now
probably going to
make
here.
I want to make that point. So many people think that all they can have is a spring garden. And I find that a fall garden sometimes is better than even thinking about a spring garden because of the life cycle of insects. They're pretty well gone and they're not the problem that you have in the fall. So don't forget, you have a great opportunity to put a fall garden in at this point now. This is Charlie Stocker with Hey Garden Guy here at the community garden. Have a great day.